Hello and welcome back to Fallout New Vegas, first reloaded in the mat. Now, this is the 100th episode of this series, so yeah, it's gone on a fair bit again. But to be fair, we should be out of here once we finish this DLC and then the Divide, and then we can just, you know, move on to the finale. Look at that bugger. That's not at all identical to the ghosts. That lobotomite just came out of nowhere. I can't shoot through the fence from what I understand. He has two cups. One robot of my two cups. I'm not gonna watch that. That sounds disgusting. Oh! Suppose he's been freed as well now. What were you using that, sir? Or madam? You honestly can't tell because... Wait, no, I think they were... programmed as female, but that doesn't really matter because they're just skeletons, so at this point it doesn't really make a lot of difference. Yeah, I honestly don't know if the game does have different animations for different genders, or if it's just physical scaling. So there's a village somewhere that we're supposed to get to. And someone had placed a mine on this thing. A mine I did not notice. But that would explain why we were advised not to walk on the pipes. So to be fair, this is the first time the pipes have betrayed me. It seems the mines are inside the pipes. Is that alive? Seems not. Okay. Okay. Well, by the map, this looks like the correct location. Oh, it's a survivor. It's not gonna attack me, is it? Oh, it did. Boo. Yeah, these guys are apparently aggressive, so... Parkour! Yeah... Also, we level up! Good, great! This is exactly what we're here for. Leveling up a ton. Wait, actually I wanted to go with max out guns, right? Yeah. And then, okay, these three stats are now on equal levels, so... There we go. Done. Okay, so let's see. There's supposed to be Christina's equipment here somewhere. In this little area. Question is exactly where. And how did the... Elijah get in here without the survivors going all crazy on him. It's important questions in life. But this looks like a sort of a... well accomplished barricade because I can't very easily get over it. Not well enough accomplished barricade there. Alright, let's see. Nope, looks pretty clean. Toilets. Oh no! I just shot a survivor. Just because he was taking a poop. Oh, his eyes are on the floor now. That's very nice. He has a club! Clearly he's armed and very dangerous. Though I'd say the correct phrase would be he's loved and very dangerous. Yeah. Though I can't really say if he's really dangerous because you saw what happened. You saw. There was death everywhere. It's just like random noises going on right now. It's very weird. And I have little to no idea as to where these items that I seek actually are. I just know they're in here somewhere. So I've heard. It's a weapon I really require. Maybe even truly desire. For it is a powerful weapon. Capable of many things. Including but not limited to popcorn. Wait, no, the gun does not make popcorn. So imagine if it did though. Yeah, I didn't really like popcorn. Hey, that's not an argument. You're still gonna pretend that you can jump on the bed. Wait, I did jump on the bed, never mind. Anything in the locker? More caps, nice. So this doesn't really look like a lot in here. Maybe it's supposed to be in there? Because it sounds like those Sierra Madre-ish radios in here. So that just might be the case. I'm gonna check out the downstairs bit first, and then we're gonna look upstairs to see if the sniper was indeed in a vantage point. Which, you know, would make sense. There is terrible news that she got caught. Ah yeah, there we go. Thank you. Oh, I didn't realize she did the drugs. Alright, where is the rifle? I need this rifle. I'm gonna repair it. I can't really use the sniper rifle to repair it now, can I? It's got mods on it. Maybe I've got some of this that I've never used, which is called a weapon repair kit. Apparently no. Oh wait, no, that would be under aid, not misc. There we go. I don't know if it looks any different. But it deals more damage. Or so I've heard. There's apparently a multitude of enemies firing at me now. And I may be dying. Also, I may be shooting a bike. Apparently not dying though. Good to know that they're looting this item immediately turned into an ambush. It's like there was planning involved. Yeah, he's down. Alright. Let's see what they have for offer. Gentlemen, do you have any ammo for me? No. And I don't think I can fix this with a brush gun, but I'm gonna try. The submachine gun is one-handed, so probably won't work either. They have a cup though, so I could get that for Muggy, but I don't really care enough. Poor lad. Poor Muggy. Alright, what do we see? Nothing. Well, in that case, let's just pretend it is nothing. Let's not go there. I thought there was also supposed to be information in there. Should probably go and check again. That eye? Alright, that's the night vision drug, isn't it? Which is kinda odd to have around, I suppose. Huh. But maybe there wasn't any information in here. Well, we got the rifle, that's what was the important part, so we can remove my personal marker and we can head to the research center and see if we can find what we see. This doesn't look very nice. Terminal, what do you have? In this test, you will take on the role of one of those evil commies infiltrating an institution of honest American learning. Don't worry, citizen, it's just for pretend. Your objective is to steal documents for that a real dirty commie traitor, which you're not, could use to brainwash our children, which you will do. This test will help us to protect our children's fragile minds from the agents of international communism. Agents like you. Just kidding, we know that you're a loyal American. Aren't you? Subjects will be informed that we are gauging the effectiveness of communist infiltration of American schools. They won't know about the cyberdogs until they actually begin the testing process. This day engages cyberdog protection protocols alongside standard automated turret systems. Test B adds protections to the previous test. Test B also includes some basic tests for the field disruptor capacitance module. Alright. And a further notice, please do not enter the residential cyberdog test area or conduct any experiments using it. The cyberdogs are still being programmed and any disturbance could have dramatic influence on their process. Restricting access in this fashion should also help to avoid any repeats of incident playtime, settlements for which are coming directly out of our budget. Dr. Gail Richardson, PhD, test engineer, cyberdog project. What's in the jar? Looks like a testicle. It's probably not a testicle. Ah, science. What a wonderful thing it is. That looks like a dead lobotomite. Let's go touch him in the bum. Or let's not touch him in the bum. Oh, Mark V's. Also sounds fine. Come on. I'm supposed to deal like 10,000 damage with this intelligence for an achievement. So come on. Let's do this. Maybe if I switch to a different sort of ammo, what do we have? Armor piercing, yeah, that'll work. Alright. That was armor piercing, right? Or was... Yeah, that was armor piercing. I suppose we could use more armor piercing, because we might have more armor piercing. I'll hold on though, but this is the sort of area where that might be useful, because apparently we're dealing with Mr. Orderlies, who are not in any way our best friends forever. In fact, I believe them to be assholes. Quite so. Is this the same terminal? Nope. The X-13 facility has loaned us their EM pulse wave module prototype for the sonic emitter for use in our data retrieval test simulations. The module allows the sonic emitter to disable certain force fields. Do not allow the subjects to leave the X-8 facility with this module. Even though it won't work outside Big Mountain, it's a security nightmare. Thank you all for your attention in this matter. Dr. Adam Figgis, MDBHDDMDDMDD, the supervisor. Yes, Project Burke involves what some less science-minded individuals might call grave robbing. Yes, we are forced into this due to budget cuts. No, none of the senior staff uses the bodies for anything else. Finally, in regards to the rumor that Project Hare engages in liquidation operations against non-military targets to procure research subjects, I will not dignify them with a response. Any other questions? While programming the new residential cyberdog module to retrieve objects thrown by human beings for purpose of enjoyment, I accidentally used an audio sample recording of its bark as the object to be fetched. The cyberdog has now become attached to the sample and displayed signs of aggressive tendencies when I attempted to recover it. I have left it in the residential reconstruction area until it is needed. I believe the cyberdog has buried it. That's nice. So the sonic emitter bark example is now in the possession of a cyberdog. Hello. Ah. I suppose we're supposed to go into the institutional desk now. Yes, seems like it. Ah. There's been a commie spy here! Maybe an American spy. Either way. Someone. Wanted to know more! About the situation. Alright, so, what are you? Let's start with the basic test. Okay.
Attention students, this is the pre-recorded voice of your pre-recorded principal, Dr. Principal Boros. You may know me as the head chief first researcher of labs Z9 and Z14. There I fought valiantly to preserve rattlesnake DNA and put it right where in the husk of another feared predator. Oh, and the tarantula hawk. Can't splice enough, I always say. Especially if you can make a magnificent cazador. Enough about me. It has come to my attention that many of you seemingly innocent children have been subverted by red propaganda. This is a most serious matter, requiring the most serious of detention. Can you spell detention? Death tension. Commie Pico traitors. Now I will send vicious cybernetic cyborg dogs through the corridors to weed all you traitors out. Skip out which among you have chosen the commie path. Especially you, Betsy Bright, who turned you down to the high school dance so you could smoke with Richie Marcus. Hall monitors will also be vigilant. Step outside during class, and they'll make sure you make a speedy jump back to your desk. Hold your urine, and wait for the proper bathroom break time.
Remember to hold your urine and wait for... Oh, well, that doesn't really help, does it? It's already without targeting data. So I don't know if that meant they were already trying to shoot the dogs as well, or it just meant that they don't actually shoot anything. Neither option sounds likely. Look at this teacher over there, he's looking so scary. So scary and mean. Shoot him in the butt. For great success. Yes. Yes. Great success will be mine if I shoot things in the butt. It is a well-known fact. Unless, of course, we are actually talking about IRL, in which case, don't actually shoot people in the butt. Don't shoot people. Yep. It is not recommended. Alright, let's see. The whole monitor is probably still mean. So it's probably best to blow it up. It's not gonna help us a lot anyway. Alright, these final cabinets are all separate, so woo. Means separate loot. Which means I should actually also loot the bottle caps. Nice. Alright, do you have the student data? Yes. Boris was a really bitter man, apparently. But I think that's only because we're playing with Wild Wasteland. Like, the names would have been different otherwise. Not even the names, but certainly the grades and such. Alright. I'm being really quiet. Being very, very quiet. I'm in the library. Wait, no, that's not how you shh people. Never mind. There's a dog somewhere. Watch out. Watch your butt. You better watch out. You better watch your butt. Because there's a dog out there. Who wants to bite that butt? And having your butt bitten doesn't sound nice. Unless you're into that stuff. But in that case, probably not by a dog anyway. Like, they usually actually bite, you know, seriously when they bite people. Unless, you know, they've been just playful. But in that case, they probably wouldn't, you know, bite your butt. Why would the commie steal student records anyway? That just confuses me. Yeah, fly through the other dog. What do you mean? How did that first shot just bust through him? Nobody's business. At all. Okay, I think we're about to recover the last piece of intel. So, which may or may not mean that we are going to be sent to the next task. Sorry, buddy. I don't want you to stab me with a flaming sword. Just sounds really inconvenient, you know? Alright, what do we have here? Lots of stuff. Right. Just stuff. Some caps there. That's nice. Because someone is actually cautious about me now. Is it you, military's head dog? Apparently not. The reason this gun was recommended to me was apparently the fact that it's completely able to take out an entire encampment of enemies before no one actually realizes what's going on. You know, that's always nice. That's always a fair bit of fun. Oh, hello. You just better not notice me at all. Because I don't want to play with you, sir. You're an asshole, I believe. And I don't want to play with assholes. Well, unless it's video game. Wait, this is a video game. But it's gonna shoot me, so it's, you know, still not very fun. Alright, let's see. Was there actually anything of benefit here? I don't think so. There is a distinct possibility that I did not look hard enough, but I'm quite under the assumption that there was nothing of interest there. Hi. It's just not even looking at me. Oh, Richie likes balls. That's good to know. Like, I don't understand why they didn't just put the Richie likes balls thing into the whole student record. Like, why does he have to say it loudly? Of course, that would be a really weird student record. That door is probably not gonna open until we actually clear out this area as well. Come on, open the door. I need to get on that floor. No. Thank you. Now, this is just a lot of balls in here. I suppose there's also some baseball bats, but, you know, it's mostly just balls. Like, why would anyone need to lock in that many balls? It's an average lock, no less. Alright. That's a lot of smoking on school property. No, no, it isn't. Oh no. There's new pups on the street. And they're mad. Mad, I say. Mad! I'm just gonna miss you repeatedly, okay? Cool. Good puppy. I suppose now we're going this way, aren't we?
Oh my! You got to the residential test! This is really Boros, by the way. Hello again. None of us thought you would get this far.
Wait, is this Boros pre-recorded or is it Boros, you know, from the Central Labs? We've had a small issue with one of our Y-17 trauma harnesses. Sadly, a member of the X-12 research team choked on a buffalo goat seat and died while working late last night. For some reason, his Y-17 trauma harness will not shut down. In fact, it has begun malfunctioning and causing the late Mr. Harris to attack other employees. Do you have any prototypes you could lend us as a means to stop it? I'm sending over the K-9000 cyberdog gun. It should do the trick. Let me know if you have any operational questions. We've had another unfortunate occurrence. One attempted to destroy Mr. Harris's trauma harness. The disaster control team member carrying the dog slipped. The gun slipped and fell, dropping the weapon. Unarmed, the team had to flee and seal off the lab. Unfortunately, your K-9000 cyberdog gun prototype was sealed inside X-12. Well, we already have one of those. We don't need more X-12s, do we? There's apparently a way to advance it further. Look at that science. It's a K9000 cyberdog gun. Ooh, this is a nice view of it as well. But to be fair, this is a good view of it. It's a gun. That's a dog. And a gun. At the same time. What are you doing down there? Come on, you should be looking at... You're supposed to be learning there, not playing poker. Bad dog. Bad dog. I accidentally picked up Nuka-Cola. I didn't mean to do that. There's not a lot of point for me to have Nuka-Colas. No? We're probably going to go into the second phase of the... thing now? Wait, is this... This is...
The residential test. Wasn't that shut down for some reason?
This looks very much like the same area.
Hostile target identified.
Another hostile target, I'm just here to have fun.
The lawful use of deadly force. Please direct complaints to your local law enforcement authorities.
Armor piercing rounds are somehow a lot more effective against these guys than the normal rounds are. I wonder why. I also wonder why I forgot that I had those. Like, those are actually really pretty good.
My pet. I'd forgotten about the old boy and the countless experiments I've done on him back in the free fire zone. Gabe? Gabe! You're about to have your favorite treat. A visitor. Won't that be nice? Don't eat the visitor, boy. Don't, please.
Apparently, Gabe is not supposed to eat the visitor. Yay! Demise of the machines! Is Gabe visible yet? Because Gabe is apparently a giant.
Gabe would bark and snarl and bite whenever anyone came to visit. That's why I replaced his legs with spare parts and fed him a steady diet of psycho waste dog chow.
Yeah. That's not a good way to be a pet owner, sir. It really is not. And I have no idea what maybe we're about to actually supposed to be headed. Looks like this way. So let's check out this part first. And once we have, I'm gonna call the episode there because... It's going to be a lengthy one, but that doesn't mean I have to actually go for an entire hour for episode 100 again. Is that something I need to do? Not really. It's something I have done in the past. It's not something I have to do, you know? Yeah. Alright, do we get to make more? No. Oh, apparently sensor modules could be useful for making auto-inject steam packs. That's cool. I don't know if that's actually of any use for me. But it's good to know nonetheless. Well, that goes into the facility again, and this one... Huh. This one leads to dead protectron, which is kind of surprising. Really? I didn't expect that. He has a hat. Wait, no. That's just goggles again. Sir? If you'd point your head over here, thank you. Get back here. I would like to ask you a question, sir.
Who's a good boy? You are.
This is probably not the best way to actually handle these things. Shipping to the apartment. Dr. Richardson, we've just received the latest shipment of dogs for the cyberdog experiment process, but well, frankly, I think our supplier screwed us. The animals must be basically feral. Every time we get close to the shipping kennels, they let out with the most god-awful hissing and, well, rattling is the only way I can describe it. Please advise, should we open the kennels or just send them back? So, Dr. Richardson's request, we opened one of those kennels from our latest shipment, the dog inside, and I used the term very loosely, appears to be suffering from a truly horrendous case of mange. And upon being released, it immediately attacked, killed, and attempted to swallow a whole specialist, Akers. Luckily, the situation has, for now, at least contained itself. As SPC, Akers was a very large man, and the creature has choked to death. Does anyone know anything about this shipment? Please advise. In light of the large number of fatalities due to the latest shipment of experimental test subjects, the shipping department is going into lockdown. I give you my personal assurance that as soon as this plague of monsters has been dealt with, I will work overtime to get your deliveries to you in a timely and efficient manner. As I am currently the only surviving member of the shipping department, however, there may still be some delays. Until then, Dr. Callis in X-13 has the best card for the area. In our last supervisor meeting, we discussed the possible benefits of the small shipping accident. We are considering studying the unexpected specimen's behavior by releasing them into our test area before removing them from the X-8 facility. The shipping department will remain in lockdown until the decision has been made. Reached, even. That sounded fun. Come and get me my sniper rifle. Me sniper rifle. Though I'm still really unsatisfied about the fact that I'm not getting a lot of ammo for me sniper rifle. I need it for me sniper rifle. The sniper rifle. He's for snipping. Should I take the Saturnite fist? Sure, let's see what the toaster can do with it. At least, I think that's what I wanted. Yeah. I think so. Okay, let's grab the magnum rounds and... Escape visible from here? Doesn't look like it just yet. How did this guy die there? Did the lobotomites actually get one? How did the lobotomites get this deep into the facility in the first place? What is going on? Anyway, I think I'll finish the episode here, so thanks for watching. I'll see you next time. I actually don't know what to expect from this one. Ah, that's smart. Oh well. You know. All for the sake of science, you know?